Sziasztok!
Hi, guys.
Hi, Georgia. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I just ate a lot of food, so I'm feeling very satisfied and looking forward
very
to chatting.
Good. Very good. So let's get started, shall we? I'm sure there are many Vikings fans in the audience today, so so I think we should start with that. Your father is the showrunner, so could you tell us a bit about how was it like working for him or with him on this project?
Working with my dad was an amazing experience. The first time, actually, I auditioned for the role of Torvi, I had to do an interview with the producer, the director, the casting, and my dad. And I did the scene, and then they played the scene.
Ouch.
Technology. Was that me or was that you?
Don't know.
Sorry about that, guys. I hope everyone still has their eardrums. They played me back the audition on a screen like this, and then I had to watch myself. So from the very beginning, my dad was very much the writer of the show. He wasn't my dad at work. But we'd always go off and have nice dinners together, and obviously it was great because I could ask him if I wanted something to be written in or if I had an idea. Instead of it having to go through a lot of people, I could send my dad a little text and say, you know, I think Torby needs a new tattoo or something, and he often listened,
And your dad is also a writer. Did it ever occur to you to try yourself in that field as well?
No, I don't think I've got the writing bug. I wish I did, because I'd love to be as successful as my dad, but I think just acting at the moment, but we'll see. You never know what the future brings.
So, nem lehet hallani? Aha. Apád egy író volt. Milyen volt vele dolgozni? Az a helyzet, hogy amikor... Nem jó.
So, did it ever occur to you during the shooting that your character could be written off at any moment?
I did find a script on my dad's desk at one point, in which my character was killed off. I don't remember, I think she was like pushed over a cliff or something. And yeah, I was obviously really upset, but I was like grateful that, you know, I'd come as far as I had, and to me, I was happy. Like, that was a good enough, you know, experience. And yeah, I didn't say anything to him, and then a couple of weeks later, I got the next script, and that scene had miraculously disappeared, and I was still alive. And I think, you know, the team at History and MGM just really loved Torvi's strong, like, female character and her bond with Lagertha. So thanks to them, my life was saved.
Milyen volt, amikor megtudtad, hogy a történetet kiírják majd a vikingekből? Az a helyzet, hogy apám íróasztalán találtam meg a forgatókönyvet, és persze nagyon fel voltam, nagyon felzaklatott, főleg azért, mert nagyon szerettem ezt a karaktert, de nem szerettem volna, hogyha egyszerűen csak eltűnik, így aztán a kemény munkának és a munkatársaimnak segítségével az életem megmenekült.
Now, obviously we have lots of video game fans around here, and I understand you also did your fair share of video game dubbing. What's that experience like?
It was super fun. I definitely would love to be properly in a video game at some stage. I just think the whole experience is so surreal. I mean, one of the interactive video games I did was like blue screen, so I got to act and perform, but when you look in the lens of the camera, the background is already there, so it's not like CGI where you add it in post. It was already in the camera lens. It was like one of the most kind of updated versions of CGI, basically, of that technology. And it was pretty epic, and it definitely got me wanting to do more. And I just think any kind of badass physical characters, that's my favorite type of role, basically.
úgy tudom, hogy szeretnél játszani, szeretnél szerepeket vállalni videójátékokban is. Tudnál erről mesélni? Igen, az egész élmény a videójátékokkal kapcsolatban meglehetősen szürreális. Főleg azért, mert rengeteg CGI-t használunk. Így aztán, amikor az embernek egy CGI képernyővel szemben kell játszani, az minden kézzelet felülmúlóan szürreális tud lenni. De nagyon szeretnék egy kemény, tökös, fizikai karaktert játszani.
So, would you have any preference of a video game like Dragon Slayer or a sci-fi or anything else?
I used to actually play The Witcher before it came out on TV. And I always used to think that would have been very cool. Or I think World of Warcraft, I'm trying to think if Travis did that. I can't remember. But yeah, something just like that probably, something physical, but still a really gripping storyline and still like a strong female. That would be the dream.
És milyen játékokban szeretnél játszani, vagy szeretnél szerepelni? Sárkányokat ölnél inkább, hogy valamilyen sci-fit játszanál? Nos, játszottam a Witcherrel, és azt nagyon szerettem, és mindenképpen szeretnék olyan karaktert játszani, mint például Travis, aki talán a Warcraftben játszott. És ennyi.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned CGI, because these days movies and TV shows are ripe with the use of CGI and digital likenesses of artists, but also there are deepfakes out there. So what's your opinion on this technology?
I think obviously technology's come such a long way, and it's incredible that now we're able to do, you know, such realistic. I mean, back in the day, if you had a stunt double, you know, that didn't look much like you, they would be featured in a movie. Like, you look back at some old films and you're like, how did anyone get away with this? You know, obviously it's so impressive now that we have the kind of technology to basically do whatever we want, but it is a bit scary that someone can literally digitally use your face on their body. I don't know if you guys have seen, like, on TikTok, they have like a lot of deep fakes of like Margot Robbie and Tom Cruise, and like, you don't know what someone could do with that. They could upload you doing something weird and then say it was you, and how you'd never be able to say, because it would look just like you. So yeah, I mean, it does kind of freak me out, but there's a dark side to all kind of advanced technology. So as long as it's used in the right way, I think it's an amazing tool, but obviously there's always that sort of like element of it being kind of so big, it's like beyond your control. Anyone can access this incredible technology from their home these days. So yeah, it is a little bit freaky.
Örülök, hogy szóba hoztad a CGI-t, mert azt szerettem volna megkérdezni, mi a véleményed róla. Az a helyzet, hogy a technológia rettenetesen sokat fejlődött. Gondoljunk bele korábban, hogyha az embernek volt egy kaszkadőre, és az játszott helyette, hiába nem úgy nézett ki, mint ő, mégis bekerült a filmbe. Most pedig a technológiával elképesztő digitális karaktereket lehet létrehozni, akik pont úgy néznek ki, mint ő. Ennek persze van hátránya is. Hiszen ha belegondolunk, például TikTokon előkerülhetnek olyan karakterek, akik úgy néznek ki, mint valaki más, akár mint én, és az emberek azt mondják, hogy ezt én mondtam, ezt én csináltam. Úgyhogy a technológia csodálatos, de egy persze ijesztő is.
As an artist or an actor, how is it different? Is it different for you to work on a TV show that goes on for many years, as opposed to a big movie franchise or a one-off blockbuster or even stage work?
I think the obvious thing with, you know, TV, and actually same with stage, is just the amount of time you have to commit to a project. You know, it's obviously incredible getting cast on something like Vikings was like the best thing that ever happened to me, but it's a huge commitment. It took up like 6.5 years of my life. And I think the nice thing with a movie is that it's sort of three or four months of like intense shooting, and then you've kind of got the rest of your year free. So, you know, now I'm getting a little bit older. Not saying I'm old, but I am creeping up to 30. You know, I don't really want to be going anywhere for 6 years. Like, I want to have a family and I want to be a bit more settled. So I think for me, looking at, you know, doing a movie, that would kind of be like my absolute goal and dream to do. And it just gives you like purpose to get into really good shape for something. It just gives you that kind of motivation. When you film something for years on end, it's it's, you know, with Vikings, it was hard to keep that motivation going for so many years.
Színészként mi a következő, mi az, amit jobban szeretsz csinálni? TV műsorokban, TV show-kban szerepelni, nagy franchise filmekben szerepelni, vagy a színpad a kedvenced? Nos, a színpadot is nagyon szeretem, de az a helyzet, hogy a vikingek volt talán az egyik legnagyobb dolog, ami történt velem, de elvett 6,5 évet az életemből. Ezért aztán úgy gondolom most, hogy telik az idő, hogy a filmekben az a csodálatos, hogy az ember oda megy, végigcsinálja a forgatást, aztán pedig az év maradék részében szabad, csinálhat bármi mást. És ezért érdekes a motiváció kérdése, mert egy filmre felkészülve a motivációt megkapod, felkészülsz a filmre, megcsinálod. Még mondjuk a vikingeknél ezt a motivációt 6,5 éven keresztül kellett fenntartani, és ez nem volt könnyű.
Who has been the biggest inspiration so far for you as an artist in your career?
I obviously, the cliche one, which is true, would be to say my dad, because really I grew up on film sets and like just seeing how hard he worked, and you know, he literally came from absolutely nothing and came from a very poor family and has literally just worked so hard, like tirelessly. I think obviously he's like my biggest inspiration, but I think in terms of looking at an actor, like I really am inspired by Alicia Vikander. I loved her work in The Royal Affair back when she was super young. And then obviously like her role in Lara Croft and stuff like that, like she's just been so diverse. And yeah, I just really respect her, you know, her kind of arc as an actor and just the different roles that she's got to play. And I think she's always kind of stayed out of the limelight and been very like tasteful and just kind of chosen to have a private family and stuff. And I think that's really like a nice way of kind of existing.
Ki volt az inspiráció? Ki az inspirációd színészként vagy művészként? A klisé válasz persze az édesapám lenne, akivel lényegében forgatásokon nőttünk fel. Nagyon szegény családból, szinte semmiből dolgozta fel magát, keményen, fáradhatatlanul. De hogyha egy színészt kell választanunk, akkor Alicia Vikander lenne a választásom, aki most arra egy igazi sokszínű művésznek nőtte ki magát, és borzasztó ízesesen is jól választ szerepeket, ezt nagyon tisztelem benne.
These days, spoilers and leaks are very prevalent. How can you manage or handle such an issue when you're shooting or after your shoot have shot something?
I think we were pretty lucky with Vikings. I don't think there were ever that many spoilers, to be honest. Everyone in Ireland where we filmed the show was super chilled and left us all really to it, and they weren't super involved or nosy. But of course, there would occasionally be something online. Someone would take a picture of us in Ireland and speculation would go, but I don't think I ever saw anything that really was a spoiler that like no one knew. I think, you know, the thing that I still get these days, less so now, but back in the day, you know, everyone with such a big series, everyone's at different parts of the show, so I'd have to be careful what I said to people because they would be like, no, spoiler please, and I'd assumed everyone had watched the whole thing. But I mean, still, I probably still spoil it to this day because people are like, oh, I was going to watch that. And I'm like, well, it's too slow. Like, it's been 6 years. So, yeah, I think we've been lucky. I don't think there were any major spoilers, but, yeah, it does happen.
Mi a véleményed a spoilerekről? Hogyan kezeled ezeket? Nos, szerencsére a vikingekkel azt hiszem, hogy elmondhatom, hogy nem voltak spoilerek. Amikor Írországban forgattuk, akkor mindenki nagyon együttműködő, nagyon segítőkész volt. Így nem szivárgott ki semmi. De persze online az emberek gondolkodnak, spekulálnak arról, hogy mi fog történni, mi történhet. De azt hiszem, elmondhatom, hogy én nem láttam spoilereket. Korábban, amikor a vikingek egy nagy, egy igazi, jelentős sorozat volt, akkor mindenki a show különböző részeit látta, kapta meg. És amikor valakinek elmondtam valamit arról, hogy mi történik a műsorban, azt mondta, úristen, spoiler! Én nekem pedig azt kellettem mondanom, hát lassú vagy, már régen lement a műsor.
Now obviously spoilers often come through social media, and as an artist you are kind of have to use social media, but what's your opinion on the whole phenomenon itself? Is it a blessing, a curse, or somewhere in between?
I had a good discussion with this a couple of weeks ago with Dan Portman, who plays Podrick on Game of Thrones, and he's a good friend of mine. And he was just saying social media is just not a healthy place. Like, it doesn't make him feel good. It's not, you know, it's not productive to him as an individual. And I think he doesn't really use it. He never used it for paid work. So, you know, if you don't have to have it, I would say don't. Like, it's not necessarily the most healthy place. For me, you know, I use it so much for work that it really, you know, I really have no option but to keep it. And I enjoy it because I enjoy connecting with fans and I enjoy the kind of fun side of it, but I also take it all with a pinch of salt. I mean, I do it for work and I switch off and I don't spend hours looking at comments or reading my inbox, or I just kind of use it as, a, you know, what it is for me, which is just a work platform. And I don't really spend much other time on it, but... I have great followers on there, and everyone's has been very nice to me. I don't often have any bad, you know, anything bad, which is, I'm lucky. So, you know, thus far it's been a good platform for me.
Mit gondolsz a közösségi médiáról? Mi a véleményed róla? Inkább áldás, vagy inkább bátok? Néhány hete találkoztam Dan Portmannel, aki Podrickot játszotta a Trónok harcában, vele beszélgettünk erről. És ő mondta azt, hogy ő nem használja, korábban sem használta, egyáltalán nem gondolja azt, hogy ez jó volna neki. Én munkára használom, és rögtön utána, amikor meg is vagyok vele, ki is kapcsolom. Az a helyzet, hogy ezt egy munka, arra használom, hogy a munkámat reklámozzam vele, hogy a munkámmal kapcsolatban tegyek fel a posztokat. Nem töltök rajta ezen kívül több időt, és így aztán nem volt negatív tapasztalatom, igazából mindenki kedves volt hozzám.
You're also involved in some super important charity work. I guess social media could be a good platform for that, but I think many young people are here, so I think they should really know what you're involved in. If you could tell us about that a bit.
Yeah, sure. I am an ambassador for a charity called the Lady Garden Foundation, which is a female a charity raising awareness about female like gynecological cancers. I had a scare myself actually when I did Vikings, and so it kind of made me think, okay, I've got this amazing platform, I've got these great fans, like what can I actually be doing to make a difference and make an impact? You know, it's nice to upload nice photos and show what you're eating and while you're on holiday, but ultimately, you know, I want to try and make some kind of a difference. So I started working with that charity to just raise awareness and raise funds for them. And you know, it's nothing, I mean, gynecological health is just nothing to be embarrassed of, but I mean, I went on Sky News in the UK to talk about my private parts, basically. I was embarrassed for a moment, and then I thought, this is going to hopefully help a lot of people. And I had so many of my fans messaging me saying, I went to get checked up, they found this, like, you know, everything's fine, or, you know, I have to go back in for another check, but I never would have gone unless you said. So that made it worth my embarrassment, made it worth it. To have other people, you know, looking after themselves. And then I also work with another charity called Alice's Ark, which is a children's cancer charity. And it's just basically tackling one type of sarcoma. It's like a really rare type of cancer called rhabdomyosarcoma. I lost a friend to that last year. And so just trying to use my platform as much as I can to kind of raise awareness for the kids that don't have a platform to speak on.
Nagyon komoly munkát végzel a jótékonyság területén. Lehet, hogy erre is lehet használni a közösségi médiát, de beszéljünk arról, hogy miket csinálsz ilyen téren. Az egyik jótékonysági egy alapítvány, aminek dolgozom, a nőgyógyászati egészséggel kapcsolatos. Amikor a vikingekben lévő szerepemet megkaptam, akkor úgy gondoltam, hogy ezt a lehetőséget ki kell használnom arra, hogy valamilyen változást elérjek, valahogy segítsek az embereken. És így talált meg engem ez az alapítvány. Voltam reggeli tévéműsorokban is, ahol beszélgettem a privát testrészeimről, ami egy olyan szégyen, amit le kellett küzdenem, és az a helyzet, hogy ha valakinek ilyen típusú problémái vannak, tehát műgyászati problémái, annak nem szabad szégyelnie, el kell mennie orvoshoz és figyelnie kell magára. A másik alapítvány, aminek dolgozom, az pedig egy gyermek rákkal kapcsolatos jótékonysági intézmény. Egy nagyon jó barátomat vesztettem el nem régen egy nagyon súlyos szarkomában, és úgy gondolom, hogy erre is oda kell figyelni, hogy az emberek erről is többet tudjanak.
So my final question before opening the floor to some questions from there is streaming has altered the landscape for shows and movies as well. How do you see the emergence of streaming platforms and how it influenced your industry?
Well, I mean, when we started Vikings, it was even before the whole like crazy streaming phase. And I kind of felt like at the time it was a bit of a shame because Vikings was such an epic show with so much amazing costume and scenes. And I always imagined it being played on a kind of bigger stream, not on a bigger screen. And obviously when you're streaming everything, you're on your laptop and it kind of feels like a waste of a whole production. But obviously I think it's amazing that we've come so far and that, you know, especially as an actor, there's so many more jobs. Like there's endless amounts of shows always being churned out. So really it's incredible. It's such a different world now to what it was. And I think, you know, if you want to be in the industry, you sort of have to keep up. But yeah, I mean, it's just opened so many doors for writers, producers, and actors, and directors to kind of get stuck into this whole, you know, other sort of streaming platform.
Egy utolsó kérdés, mielőtt a közönséghez fordulnánk. Mit gondolsz a streamingről és a streaming felemelkedéséről? Nos, a rövid véleményem az, hogy ez hihetetlen. Amikor a Vikingeket forgattuk, akkor kezdődött el ez, és nyilván úgy gondoltam, hogy mivel ez a show annyira nagyszabású volt, eposzi, csodálatos kosztümökkel, helyszínekkel, hogy a nagyobb képernyőt érdemelne, mint hogy az ember a laptopján nézze, de ugyanakkor pedig azt is látni kell, hogy így rengeteg emberhez jutsz el. Ezen kívül rengeteg munkát teremt, ami ugyanúgy hihetetlen, hiszen ha az ember dolgozni akar ebben az iparban, akkor mindenféleképpen lépést kell ezzel tartania. De ami fontos az, hogy rengeteg új lehetőséget kapnak rendezők, írók, színészek, mindenki az iparágban.
And now let's open the floor for questions. Ha szeretnétek kérdezni, itt kollégánál van egy mikrofon. Annyit szeretnénk kérni, hogy a mikrofonba is hangosan beszéljetek, mert alig hallunk bármit, úgyhogy és majd megpróbálunk fordítani.
I'll answer anything, pretty much. So, make the most of it, guys. I'm feeling open and willing to discuss the gossip.
Hello.
Hi.
So, I really loved your character in Vikings, Torvi, and I think she's really special. So my question would be, is there anything that stayed with you after having played her?
That's a great question. Yeah, for sure. I mean, I always joke that Torvi was just a badass and she was a strong woman. And I'm a bit of a wuss in real life. So I like to think I brought some of her strength to my real life. She taught me a lot. We kind of grew up together on the show. When I started shooting, I think I was 17 or 18 and she's meant to be 16 or something when the show starts. So we kind of grew up together and I tried to just inject as much of my personal life into that character. And I think, you know, kind of growing up alongside her, she taught me so much about, you know, being resilient and always asking what you want and never ever being deterred. You know, when her and Uber, when Uber wants to travel the world, she's like had a lot of failed relationships and she just says to Uber, like, I want to come with you, like I want to be with you and this is what I want. And I think I kind of definitely hope that I've brought some of that sort of strength and resilience into my personal life.
Torvit, mint karaktert, és azt szeretném megkérdezni, hogy van-e valami, ami...
Kérdések? Valaki?
Viking úri emberek ott középen.
Jó.
I want to ask, what was the most challenging part to play Torvi? I mean, learning the fighting choreography or stuff like that.
I think for me, definitely the stunts were challenging at first to get used to, just because your body is just moving in such a weird way. Like, I go to the gym like 6 days a week, so I was like, oh, I'm pretty physically fit, you know, I'll be able to do it. But swinging a sword around and a shield at the same time is so confusing. I think the thing that I learned was that it doesn't matter if I'm not perfect. It doesn't matter if I'm perfect, but what matters is that on screen, you're performing and you're acting. And so, you know, when it came up to your close-up, if you just looked like you were smashing something and just did it with absolute, like, dedication and showed it in your face, you knew that shot was going to make the cut. So I think it was just learning my angles, learning, you know, a fierce turnaround over the shoulder. All these kind of things make that last cut. And so I just basically, with time, practice. But yeah, stunts was hard. And then any scene, any kind of emotional scene would always be tough, because, you know, I'm very emotional and I would cry whenever I got a sad scene, you know, when, spoiler alert, Lagatha dies, I would read the scripts and I would cry. But by the time I'd get onto set, you've got to then do that scene 15 times. So by the last scene, I'm like, I don't have any tears left to cry. So that was always a bit of a challenge. So those would be my two, like, hardest things. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Még valaki. Biztos vagyok benne, hogy még vannak kérdések ott kint. Eresszétek szabadjára a kérdéseket.
Oh, she's going again. Come on up. Oh, here we go.
Hi. Did Catherine Winnick taught you something in, like, acting and in, like, being a shield maiden, you know?
100%, yeah. She called me this morning. I have to call her back. She definitely took me under her wing when my character started becoming, you know, a warrior. I definitely looked to Catherine to learn some of those, like, as I was just saying, the fierce moments on screen and with the camera. She just told me, just to, if you believe that you're the most badass person, it's going to translate. So it's kind of all about confidence. And just watching her and how phenomenal she was at all the stunts, such an amazing actor, but also, you know, just so, so sweet and generous to me. Like, we just formed such good friendship. So when I read the script that her character was dying, I just was so devastated. I was so upset. And it was really hard. Like, her last few days on the show were so emotional, but I did, you know, she left, and I just felt like that would be a friend I'd probably have, you know, for life. So yeah, that's a good question. She taught me a lot.
One of my favorite parts of watching a show and the cast are the bloopers. So another question would be, do you have a favorite funny memory from filming on set?
I do have a couple of funny memories. I mean, obviously, the times, many times where we would just get the giggles on, like, Gustav would be set off, who plays Floki, and then Travis. And then once everyone's laughing, it's just impossible to film a scene, especially Vikings, which is very serious. So you can imagine, like, a bunch of actors just laughing in these, like, big warrior outfits. Travis and Alexander Ludwig would just do a lot of pranks to each other. I think one of the first days I was on set, Alexander trapped Travis in a portaloo and actually pushed the portaloo over. And he got in a lot of trouble for that. But, I mean, it's not my kind of humor. I don't like that kind of, I don't like to be teased or, like, you know, anything gross happening. But it was funny to watch. And Travis put a frog down my dress at some stage, which he thought was really funny. So yeah, there were moments, there were a lot of moments of hysteria on the show over the 6 years. Yeah, I actually wish there were more blooper reels that we could watch, because they must have hours of footage of us just doing weird, weird things. I wish I could see them all.
Na, még 2-3 kérdése van időnk, ott hátul. Vagy, bocsánat. Majd akkor itt elől is, nem sokára.
First of all, sorry for my bad English, I'm trying.
Hangosabban léci.
Okay. We see in Torvi so much amazing scene. What was your favorite when you feel yourself the most comfortable and content the character?
I think, I mean, a lot of the scenes with the kids in, I really felt were really special. It's no secret, I bang on about it all the time, I can't wait to be a mum. And that's one thing I loved about my, you know, my character of Torvi was just that she, I mean, I know she lost a couple of her kids along the way, awkward, but she loved her kids and she was a great mum. And I think all the scenes that I had, I got to be with these cute little kid actors who were so talented and so brave, like doing these full-on scenes without their parents anywhere near, was probably when I felt the most comfortable and at peace. And I just felt like that was what Torvi really loved doing, was being a mum. And so, yeah, that those were the kind of moments where I just felt, you know, most content and most calm and most, you know, at peace. But I also loved, if I'd get into a battle scene and I knew a stunt really well and I felt really confident, those are also times where you just thought that it was like just the coolest job in the world. Like, yeah.
Bocsi, én most magyarul fogok kérdezni, de ugye most nagyon pörögnek a képregény filmek, sorozatok, hogyha esetleg eljátszhatnál a Marveltől vagy a DC-től egy karaktert, akkor melyik lenne az?
So, the question is that comic book adaptations are really right now, and the question was if you could play any superhero, Marvel, DC, or any other comic book hero, who would it be?
I don't want to give a really basic answer because I feel like it's really obvious to say like Superwoman or Catwoman, or obviously all of those roles I'd love to play. But I think if I was going to play like a comic book character, I'd have to really deep dive and do some research of a really unusual character that hasn't been used, because the Marvel Universe and stuff like that is, I mean, all of those characters are cool. It'd be fun to play any of them. But I think in terms of a comic book character, to dig up one that had, you know, just hasn't been used as much and is more unusual, is probably the route I'd like to go down. So I'm going to do some research and I'll get back to you when I've decided.
Na, még két kérdésre van időnk.
Hi, do you have any friend from the show in your personal life?
Yes, yeah, so I stay in contact with Catherine, who plays Lagatha, and Alex Ho, who plays Ivar the Boneless. I'm in contact really often, and Alexander Ludwig, who plays Bjorn, and Marco, who plays Fitzirk, and Jordan, who plays Uber. So all of his sons, Ragnar's sons, and Lagatha, and Raga, who plays Gunnhild, probably, they're the people I stay in contact with most. And the great thing about doing these Comic Cons is there's always a chance that you can see them, which you wouldn't normally necessarily, because we're all other, you know, sides of the world. So, but yeah, I miss them. It was a good, we had a good group, and we had a lot of fun when we were together. So yeah, I miss them all.
Utolsó kérdésre van lehetőség. Ott.
Hello, my question is, did you have any prop with which you had huge problem or made your life hell during
a prop? Yeah, it's a good question. I mean, Torvi famously, like, she kills Erlander, her first husband, with with an arrow. And that was tricky because when you're basically shooting with a prop arrow, I don't know if you guys know, but if I'm holding the prop arrow like this, you basically have to drop the arrow and then shoot. So everything happens, because you then could just shoot someone, basically. So it all takes a lot of timing, and I'm a very nervous person, so I was just such a wimp, and I was just too scared to like do the whole dropping and blah, blah, blah. So yeah, probably the bow and arrow was the hardest bit of kit, because obviously it could go horribly wrong. Whereas if you've got a fake axe or a fake sword, the worst that's going to happen, if it hits your fingers, it might hurt you. But yeah, the arrow was a little bit scary. So, but it looked so badass, and I love, by the end we had it strapped to her back, and I just thought that looked so cool. So yeah, but that was probably the hardest one.
Now, before I let you go, just I'm sure many people would love to know what you're working on or where they can see you next, if you can share.
I hate to be that person who's like, there are things in the pipeline and I can't tell you, but I hope there are things that I'll be able to say soon. And until then, I'm just auditioning. You know, it's a hard industry, it's a hard job. And I think I don't often hear actors kind of speak out about how tough it is and how, you know, you can be working one minute and then not the next. You know, I'm just hustling and hoping to get a role that really is, you know, inspires me and yeah, fingers crossed, it'll be soon.
So, mind dolgozol mostanában, mi a következő műsorod? Az a helyzet, hogy nem szeretnék az az ember lenni, aki azt mondja mindig, hogy közelednek dolgok, mindjárt hamarosan lesznek új dolgok, de az a helyzet, hogy valóban remélem azt, hogy olyan dolgokat találkozhatnak hamarosan a kedves nézők, amikben részt veszek, de valójában amit csinálok, az az, hogy meghallgatásra járok. Ez egy nehéz iparág, és nehéz szerepeket kapni.
Georgia, thank you so much for spending time with us and answering questions. We hope to see you soon.
Thank you so
and
much.
Wishing you all the best. És egy nagy tapsot szeretnék kérni Georgiának.
Thanks, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you.